it is my goal this afternoon to be able to empower you with the knowledge so that you will be able to figure out whether these and other common scenarios that you may identify in yourself or a loved one, whether these things are normal, whether they're not, and most importantly, what to do about them. I want you to raise your hand or shout out yes if in the last year you have misplaced your keys, glasses, wallet, pocketbook. Every morning, all your life, you spend 5, 10, 15 minutes, you know, hunting around the house, you know, looking for things, and now you're getting a little bit older and you're still spending 5 or 10, 15 minutes hunting around the house for things. Well, guess what? That's probably normal for you and not something to worry about. But on the other hand, if you were always someone who was very organized, you never had trouble finding things, and now you're spending 5, 10, 15 minutes, maybe 20 minutes, maybe an hour hunting around the house looking for things, well, that could be a problem. So the point I'm trying to make here is it's not only what the problem is, but whether it represents a change from the way things used to be. And now we are going to dive into the 7 steps to managing your memory. And we are going to start with step 1, learn what is normal memory. The first part of our memory system I want to tell you about is our file clerk. So let's say there's a piece of information you want to remember, like somebody's name that you just met. Well, our file clerk has to come over and take in that piece of information. And the file clerk is actually part of the brain. It's your frontal lobe right behind your forehead. And so it's the frontal lobe file clerk's job to take information in from the outside world and then to put it into the physical memory file cabinet. In Alzheimer's, is that Alzheimer's damages and ultimately destroys the file cabinet. So the borderline between normal memory and Alzheimer's disease dementia is this mild cognitive impairment. But these amyloid plaques inside the brain get bigger and bigger and bigger, and they start to disrupt the brain cells. And when it damages the brain cells, it then releases another protein called tau. So these are the plaques and the tangles that you might have heard about in Alzheimer's disease. Acetylcholine is one of the most important of these chemicals inside the cells. So in Alzheimer's disease, the levels of acetylcholine drop. These are medications like donepezil, whose brand name is Aricept, rivastigmine, whose brand name is Exelon, and galantamine. All of these medications help to raise up the levels of acetylcholine in the brain. The Mediterranean diet and some of its cousins, like the MIND diet that I'm going to be talking about, are the only diets that has been shown in study after study after study to be good for the brain. Chocolate in small amounts has been shown to benefit thinking and memory and mood. We have also learned that we need sleep to keep our memories for a lifetime. So there are some studies that suggest that having one alcoholic beverage a day for both men and women, note that I said just one, is not harmful and may actually be helpful. Dr. Buzzin, isn't there some magic, bullet out there that I can take that can improve my memory? I answer, yes, there is. It's called exercise. Exercise truly is the magic bullet. And if someone is concerned about their memory, the way to do it, I always recommend starting by talking to your primary care doctor. But if your doctor isn't sure, or if you are not satisfied with the answer that your doctor is giving you, which is one of the reasons we wrote the book, to empower you with the knowledge to know what your doctor should be doing. So if you're not satisfied, go and see a memory expert.